Good morning, students. This is the lesson of class 9 for the subject of geography, topic calculation of longitude and time, which is covered in chapter 2, latitudes and longitudes, starting on page number 25 of your textbook and is being submitted to you on 19th of April 2021. Students, in the previous session, we had discussed about the latitudes and longitudes, and we all know that there are overall 360 longitudes, 179 on the eastern hemisphere, 179 on the western hemisphere, prime meridian, and 180 degree east and west longitude, which is a single longitude or meridian. They all forms overall 360 longitudes. And we also know that Earth completes its one rotation in about 24 hours. It basically means that Earth covers 360 longitudes in 24 hours. So, how many longitudes is covered in 1 hour? That is 360 divided by 24, and we get the answer as 15. So 15 longitudes is covered in 1 hour. It basically means, similarly, to cover 1 degree longitude and time, longitude, the time required is 60 divided by 15, that is 4 minutes. As we all know that 1 hour comprises of 60 minutes, and 15 longitudes are being covered in 1 hour. So that's why 60 divided by 15, and it becomes 4 minutes. It basically means that 1 degree longitude, to cover 1 degree longitude, there is a requirement of 4 minutes. So, Earth covers 1 degree longitude in every 4 minutes. Thus, if it is 12 noon at 0 degree longitude, it must be 4 minutes past 12 noon towards the east at 1 degree east longitude. It is because we all know that the sun rises from the east. So obviously, sun rays strike the eastern hemisphere earlier as compared to the western hemisphere. Or it must be 1 p.m. at about 15 degree east longitude. Whereas in the west, it will be 1 hour less, that is 11 a.m. at 15 degree west longitude. As I told you, this is because Earth rotates from west to east, as sun rises first in the east. So you have to memorize EGA, means east, gain, add, and WLS means west, lose, subtract. I hope you understood with this. Here, a more elaboration. This means that for each 1 degree longitude, towards the east, 4 minutes are to be added. And each 1 degree longitude towards the west, 4 minutes are to be subtracted. Right, children? So, let us continue and discuss about our next topic. That is local time. So, students, the local time of any place is obtained by the overhead sun at noon. I'm repeating it. The local time of any place is obtained by the overhead sun at noon time. For each degree of longitude, the local time varies by 4 minutes. For example, the longitude of Mumbai is 73 degree east and New Delhi is 77 degree east. So if local time means the sun time at Mumbai is 12 noon, so what will be the local time at Delhi? So the difference of longitudes between both the places, Mumbai and New Delhi, is 77 degree minus 73 degree. It becomes 4 degrees. And we all know that 1 degree is being covered in 4 minutes. So to cover 4 degree, it will take 4 into 4. 4 minutes. Okay? That will be overall 16 minutes. So the local time at Delhi is 12 plus 16 minutes. That becomes 12:16 p.m. 16 minutes is added because Delhi lies east of Mumbai. Now children, let us practice a few more questions to find out local time when we know the longitude. So here is an example for you. If at GMT, GMT is Greenwich Meridian time or the prime meridian, 0 degree, the local time is 12 noon. So find the local time at station A at 60 degree east and station B at 30 degree west. So at station A, the longitudinal difference will be 60 plus or minus 0 prime meridian, 0 degree. So that will be 60 degree difference. Then if 1 degree covers in 4 minutes, so how much time it will take to cover 60 degrees? It becomes 60 into 4, that is 240 minutes. 240 minutes, as we all know, 1 hour covers 60 minutes. So 240 divided by 60 and it becomes 4 hours. So there is a gap of 4 hours. As station A is located to the east, so it will be 4 hours ahead of Greenwich prime meridian. So remember, east gain add, EGA. So we are going to add because 12 noon time is there at prime meridian or Greenwich meridian time, then plus 4 hours, that is equal to 16 hours. And if we are going to convert it into the other format, it will be 4 p.m. So our answer is 4 p.m. So at station A, the time is 4 p.m. if it is 12 noon at the prime meridian. Understood? Now the second is, the second station at station B, which lies at 30 degree west longitude. So the difference in longitude will be 0 degree plus 30 degree, that will be always, that will be 30 degree, right? 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes, means it takes 4 minutes to cover 1 degree longitude. That's why to cover 30 degree longitude, we multiply it with 4. It becomes 120 minutes. Now 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. That's why 120 again divided by 60, that becomes almost 2 hours. So as the station B is located to the west, and in the west we subtract, right, WLS. So as the station B is located to the west of GMT, Greenwich Meridian Time, it will be 2 hours behind GMT. That's why we will subtract the values from 2 hours from 12. That will become 10 a.m. So here you have to be very careful about the about a.m. and p.m. also, right? I hope you understand with this. Now let us discuss about the time zones, children. Time zones and standard time. Right? Students, now we know that every place at different longitude has its own local time. But it can cause utter confusion if we keep the local time of a place, as the clocks and watches would have to be constantly altered when we travel from one place to another. So to overcome the confusion, the earth has been divided into 24 time zones. Here it is. This picture shows the 24 time zones. Each zone covers 15 degree longitude. Yes. So each zone here, it almost, these are the 24 zone, and each zone covers 15 degree longitudes. The time of the whole zone is determined on the basis of central meridian of that place. These red color lines are the central meridians. India have one standard time zone, but like here, but other countries with large east-west extent as Russia, Canada, USA have more than one time zones, as you can notice here and on this part. So students, what is the standard time? The uniform time based on a central meridian is known as the standard time. While fixing the time zones, the time at Greenwich Prime Meridian has been selected as mean time. So 0 degree is the mean time. Thus, if it is 12 noon at Greenwich, 15 degree east will be, it will be 1 p.m. and at 30 degree east it will be 2 p.m. So at 15 degree it will be 1 p.m. and at 30 degree east it will be 2 p.m. So there is a gap of almost 1 p.m. The time fixed with reference to Greenwich is called the Greenwich Mean Time or GMT. Now children, let us discuss about the Indian Standard Time. Indian Standard Time in India, 82 degree 30 minutes east or 82 and a half degree east longitude is the central meridian. It passes through Allahabad at the confluence of River Ganga and Yamuna. It is known as Standard Indian Standard Meridian or ISM. The Indian Standard Meridian is 5.5 hour ahead of Greenwich Mean Time, right? As here, the longitudinal difference will be again 82 degree 30 minutes east. 82 degree 30 minutes. And it will be multiplied by 4 and this will become 330 minutes or all of 5.5 hours. So obviously the time gap between the Greenwich Mean Time and Indian Standard Time is 5.5 hours. Now children, this is the question time. So let me ask you a few questions, after which you may pause the lesson for 3 minutes. First is, Earth covers 1 degree longitude in every dash minutes. Number 2, local time of any place is obtained by the dash at noon. Number 3, in India, dash longitude is the central meridian. Now children, let us discuss their answers. So answer number 1 is 4 minutes. Answer number 2, the overhead sun. And answer number 3 is 82 degree 30 minutes east longitude. Now let us continue the topic and discuss about the international date line. The line of longitude 180 degree is 1 and the same for east or west of prime meridian. Since it is diametrically opposite of Greenwich meridian, it causes a time difference of a full day. Right? So as if in the prime meridian it is midnight, this will be 12 noon at the opposite side. For example, suppose we start traveling from 0 degree to the westward. On reaching 180 degree west, the time is decreased by 12 hours. Whereas at 180 degree east from Greenwich Meridian time, the time increases by 12 hours. That is, overall there is a difference of 12 plus 12, that is exactly 1 day. When crossing the international date line from west to east, a day is deducted. We usually lose a day. Say for example, you fly from United States to Japan on Tuesday morning. As you are traveling to west direction, as soon as you cross the international date line, it is Wednesday. So here you lose a day. while moving towards the west from USA to Japan. Now, on a reverse trip, you fly from Japan to United States on Monday. So, you had started your journey on Monday morning. As you cross the international date line, the day changes to Sunday. So, here it's a gain of a day. You gain a day here. So, moving west, one day lost. Moving east, one day gain. Now, as if you can notice, here the international date line is not a straight line. It is basically zigzag in nature. Now, because to avoid the confusion of having different dates within the same country, the date line bends and goes zigzag at Bering Strait, Fiji, Kiribati Islands, and some other islands of Pacific Ocean. Students, I hope you have understood this topic. This is about your international date line. Now, this is the question time. So, let us recapitulate the topic by means of a quick retest. So, the questions are, how many time zones are present on the earth? Number two, the Indian Standard Time, that is IST, is ahead of Greenwich Mean Time. Number three, dash line is a zigzag line. Number four, when crossing international date line from west to east, a day is dash. So students, you may now pause the lesson for 5 minutes for writing the answers. Now children, let us discuss their answers. First, there are 24 time zones on the earth. The Indian Standard Time is 5.5 hours ahead of Greenwich Mean Time. Number three, international date line is a zigzag line. Number four, when crossing international date line from west to east, a day is deducted or reduced. I hope you all have understood the topic very well. So you all are required to read chapter 2 and the assignments at least twice and complete the following books back exercise, that is A, answer in brief, question number 13, 14 and 16. Give reason 1, 2, 3, 6 and 7. With this, I conclude this interactive session. Thank you.